phrasal verbs or group verbs are the most important parts in English language, and we are often confused with this very matter. One of the toughest also, because it requires a hectic task to memorize all these things. But memorizing will not only help you to understand all this matter, so we should make one proper and distinguished video that will make a verified list of all these things. Further, the formal procedure to learn these things, then we can make some shortcuts, or we can make some way out with which make the matter easier. So this video is the formal one, or the first one, you can say, introduction to phrasal verb or group verbs. Hopefully this one will help you, and most importantly, you have to note down those things which are important. Don't write down everything, only those things which are important here. Go through this video, sure.
Here you start phrasal verbs. First we'll go through the definition or the explanation, so that we can have a formal and valid idea of all these things. Afterwards, we'll go through the shortcuts or the easier methods to make learning easier. But more than that, what we have to do for this one, we have to be extremely concerned and careful. What's a phrasal verb? A phrasal verb is a verb followed by a preposition or an adverb. The combination creates a meaning different from the original verb alone. So when the verb was original, it did have different meaning, and when it is a phrasal verb, it does have a different meaning. So the definition, we should have a look again. A phrasal verb is a verb followed by a preposition or an adverb. Followed by a preposition or an adverb. So this much should be the easier format for definition. Phrasal verbs are part of a large group of verbs called multi-part or multi-word verbs. The preposition or adverb that follow the verb is sometimes called particle. Phrasal verbs and other multi-word verbs are an important part of the English language. However, they are mainly used in spoken English and informal text. This should be avoided in academic writing, where it is preferable to use a formal verb such as to postpone rather than to put off. So when you write formal writing, you should use to postpone instead of using to put off. To get, few examples are there. To get means to obtain. I need to get a new battery for my camera. Here to get, one means to obtain, another one means to meet. Why don't we all get together for lunch? Types of phrasal verb. We have transitive phrasal verb as well as intransitive phrasal verbs. Now, this should be written, prepared in a fair format with utmost importance. Though informally spoken, this does have a valid part in question number 5B, and that provides you 4 marks. 8 pieces of example will be there, question will be there, each consists of half marks, so 4 marks. Further than, it makes a sentence look far better. The phrasal verbs need an object in order to be used. I made of an excuse. Here made of. Now, this need object, so I made up an excuse. So excuse is object here, and made of, this is the phrasal verb here. The transitive phrasal verbs. You can separate some of the transitive phrasal verbs. It means you can place the object between the verb and the particle. I looked the word up instead of writing looked up. Instead of writing looked up, what they have done? What is done here? The object is added here. This is the object, and this is the particle, and here you can see the verb. Here you can see the verb. So that also you can do. However, some verbs can be separated and the object must be placed after the particle. I will look into the matter. We cannot write, we will look the matter into. We cannot write like that. So it will be this one only. Look into, we cannot divide that one. Some phrasal verbs can take an object either between the verb and particle or after the particle. I picked up the book. I picked the book up. So you can see this is the particle, this is the verb, this is the particle, this is the verb, and this is the object. Note, however, if the object is a pronoun, it must be placed between the verb and the preposition. I picked it up. Intransitive phrasal verb, unlike the transitive one, these verbs don't have an object. Keep it in mind, this verb will not have any object. My car broke down. There is no object added here. Here we have the second part of our phrasal verbs. A phrasal verb is equal to a verb plus participle. For example, put off particle, not participle, put off, put is verb, off is particle. I put off my trip. That means I postponed my trip. So, put is verb, off is, we should not speak it preposition. Instead, we should call it particle. That is why in question paper, it is written, fill in the blanks with appropriate words instead of writing appropriate preposition. The particles looks like preposition, but it does not function as preposition. He woke up at 6:30 a.m. Strangers woke him up. The verb and the particles have special meaning here. The verb and the particles do have special meaning. So you look, he woke up. That is, up is particle. And the second one, again woke up we have, that is also particle. So we should not consider particle and preposition same. Particles are part of the verb phrase. And they often change the meaning of the verb. He looked up at the skyscraper. He looked up a word in her dictionary. Now look, he looked up, that is preposition, at the skyscraper. Now second one you see, she looked up a word in her dictionary. When you say looked up, that is preposition, but looked up a word. Now, a word, that is object. Looked up a word is object. So, that is going to be particle. When you use the same verb with a different particle, the meaning changes. First, this one we have to know. Put up is different. Put on is different. Put away is also different, put back is also different. When it is put off, that means to postpone something. Put on means to wear or cover our body with clothes. Put away means to put something in its original place. Put back, to return something in its original place. Some phrasal verbs have more than one meaning. Keep on means to continue. Keep on means not to remove something. Take off means to remove. Take off means to leave. Many phrasal verbs and one word verbs have similar meaning. Wake up, awaken, same meaning. Go on, to continue, same meaning. Take off or remove, same meaning. Phrasal are less formal and more common in everyday speech. This is a common use and make the sentence, make the statement better. Few examples. This is the first class and second one. So, we are not going to each and everything. We'll make it shorter, smaller, and colorful. So a few examples are provided here. Just like give up means abandon, turn out means to produce, carry on means to continue, put off means to postpone, turn down means to reject, look after means to take care of, get at means to attain, call at means to visit, bring up, that means train to do work, call on a brief visit to, and put on wear. These are the mostly used phrasal verbs, very common. So first I have provided you with this short of phrasal verbs. Later we'll discuss further also. Now here we have a practice set. We have only 5 here. Fill in the blanks with the suitable phrasal verbs. You are provided with the option give up, put off, look after, call on, and put on. Just in the previous page we learned the meaning of this thing. See, dash a new dress. I blank hurry in the absence of his father. You must blank smoking. I will blank you at evening today. The match has been blank until tomorrow because of bad weather. So this one you try by your own. Once you have tried these things, just wait. Here I am providing you the answers. See, put on a new dress. I look after hurry in the absence of her father. You must give up smoking. I'll call on you at evening today. The match has been put off until tomorrow because of bad weather. So just note down the answers too. So here we conclude the second part of this phrasal verb, and slowly and regularly, almost every day, we'll carry on with each new topic. Hope this will come in use. Thank you.